In this video, we will be configuring two-factor authentication. So I've referenced a previous video, but this focus will be on two-factor authentication with FortiToken Mobile, how to configure push notification on our FortiGate firewall, and then some basic troubleshooting. Okay, so just a quick recap as to how the firewall is configured. We have a firewall policy which where traffic coming in from our SSL VPN tunnel interface to our internal network, referencing the TTP Fortinet user, which is within the SSL VPN user group. So once it matches this policy, then it has access to the 192.168.112 network. And just confirming the SSL VPN settings configuration specifics, we also see that that same user group is there. So now let's just do the additional step of adding that second factor of authentication. Okay, so to do this, let's go to our user and authentication FortiToken section. You should see the tokens there like I do, but just for demonstrational purposes, I'm going to delete them and import free trial tokens in the case that you don't have them there already. And then one quick sidebar here is if you were to have clicked create new, you can import hard tokens or mobile tokens if you've purchased them, right? So when you do purchase them, they will be associated with an activation code. So for example, if you bought 25 FortiToken mobile tokens, then one activation code will come along with your licensing. You pop in that activation code and then all 25 will be showing up in here. Once we have the tokens imported on the FortiGate, let's associate them now with our specific user. So we'll just select two-factor authentication on that user and then associate a token. And then let's just put in an email address. Okay, and then once I hit okay, then that email will be sent out. All right, once you receive the email, then you just click on the QR code attachment. And there we go. Now, the next step is to just make sure that we have FortiToken installed on our smartphone. All right, so once we have FortiToken Mobile installed onto our smartphone, then we would just click the plus sign in the top right corner, and then we would click scan barcode in the bottom left there. And now after successfully scanning that barcode, now we can actually see this six-digit code that's going to be recycling every 60 seconds. All right, let's put it to the test now when we're actually connecting via VPN. There we go. So now let's just find our token code, 442.2.2.1.6. There we go. Perfect. And now we've accessed the VPN using two-factor authentication. All right, so it's great now that we have that second factor of authentication, but what if we want to take it one step further? What if we want to be able to prevent the user from having to actually manually enter that six-digit code every single time they're trying to have this second factor of authentication? Well, how we can address that is, let's go to our WAN interface. So if we access WAN 1, and let's ensure that FTM is enabled, right? So this would be, this FTM administrative access feature is pretty much so that, let's say any remote user is trying to authenticate to VPN and using our use case scenario here. Well, then if FTM is listening on the firewall's WAN interface where the request would be coming in, then the two-factor authentication response can be accepted via the push notification. So let's enable that right now. All right, and additionally, let's go into the CLI and type in config system FTM-push, and then let's set the server IP as 166.166.1.2, and let's set the server-port to be 8082, right? I'm just picking this random port right now. And then let's set the status to be enable. So just a brief explanation here is that when a user gets a push notification on their mobile phone, which will get prompted once we authenticate with the correct username and password to the FortiGate, but once they get that push notification, then as soon as they hit accept on the notification, then the following IP address and port is going to receive that traffic, which is going to be, in this case, our FortiGate's WAN 1 public IP. So just be cognizant of this server port and the IP to make sure that that traffic is actually going to reach that FortiGate's WAN IP. Otherwise, then you're going to hit the accept button and nothing will actually work, right? So let's test that now. All right, let's test it out in action now. Awesome, there we go. So we got the login request there. Now we just have to hit approve. And we can see the push notification must have got back to the FortiGate because we are seeing the tunnel establishing. And there we have it. The tunnel is established here. All right, and just a couple troubleshooting tips in case you run into any type of issues. So let's say, for example, the problem is that initially when you're associating an email address with our specific user, that the email isn't actually arriving to the end user. First thing that I would probably check is, you know, really just to make sure that there's not some type of custom email server that you have under the system settings, because the email is actually being generated by the FortiGate firewall using FortiGate's internal email relay. So there's probably a pretty good chance that that one's going to be up. But if, for example, you had some type of internal SMTP server that was maybe an outdated one, maybe that's why you're not receiving the email. Also, possibly maybe you have a spam filter or a mail filter that's blocking that email from getting through so that you can scan that barcode. Another one we could look at would be the FTM push command. So let's just set that diag debug application FTM-push-1 and then diag debug enable. And then let's just go and try again to re-authenticate. Okay, there we have it. So we can see that some information is seen on our debug here. Once I hit approve, then we're going to see even more here, right? So it just gives us a bit of an idea to be able to follow the traffic, see if we can understand what could be happening based on the debug. Additionally, too, would be to check the port that we had configured previously, right? So config system FTM-push. If we're receiving that accept and deny box notification on our mobile phone and we don't actually see that traffic coming into our phone when we hit accept, we don't actually see any type of response from our mobile phone. Maybe it's because the mobile phone can't actually communicate correctly with the FortiGate, and this would be the configuration we'd be relying on at that point. So we'll run through the test again right now, but let me run a packet sniffer for 8082 as well, just to confirm that traffic is actually coming into the firewall. Because in your case, if you didn't see that traffic coming in, that could indicate that there might be something in between the phone and the FortiGate. So let's type in 8082 here, and then let's run that packet sniffer here. We're starting it up. And then now, all right, now I've re-authenticated. The token push is seen on the mobile phone. No packets have come in yet. Let me hit approve. And then we'll see that the packet capture is showing packets have arrived. So I can, you know, get that visibility to make sure that port forwarding rule, or that there's just, you know, no issue between the phone and the FortiGate for communication. So I think one thing that's worthy of consideration is the following scenario. So in this particular video tutorial that we had here, we were thinking about, okay, let's, you know, use one type of application such as, you know, VPN to a specific firewall. And then we have a token that's associated with the firewall itself that we use for a second factor of authentication. But let's consider a use case where maybe we have multiple FortiGates, or maybe we have different vendor firewalls, and we have additionally, we have switches, we have access points, we have multiple different network appliances in our networks, or, you know, even amongst different cities, municipalities. Maybe in that case, we want to consider something more centralized. So if we, for example, are able to place those same tokens, but instead of them being on a FortiGate, they're on something centralized like a FortiAuthenticator, well, then now we can take in feeds from various different locations and leverage just one purchased FortiToken per user, which might be a little bit more centralized and scalable. But ultimately, just one thing to consider, this option that we've shown here, that this will absolutely work for anything that could be specific to the FortiGate where the tokens reside. So that kind of wraps things up. Thanks everybody for joining, and we'll see you in the next video.